Hello children, this is your English ma'am speaking. Happy to come upon with an interesting lesson, Mowgli Grows Up. Here you are going to know about a young boy who grew up with the animals. Being a young boy, how great! He prepared himself to obey the law of the jungle, and he was dare enough to face hard times in his jungle life. Now, let's move on to the iConnect part. In this iConnect part, you can see some pictures. Each pictures are very colorful and meaningful. In this iConnect part, you can know animals can often be very dedicated and careful parents. If a five sense creature of an animal very dedicated and careful parents, how will be the human? We are also very dedicated and careful in all our things what we do. Am I right, my dear children? Let's we see how the animals are very dedicated and careful parents. Each pictures depict all the mother animals teaches good things. All the mother animals are very dedicated and a careful parent. Let's we see how it is. In the first picture says, the cub is telling to us with a joy, "Hi, my mum looks after me till I am 8 years old." Till the cub turns 8 years old, its mother taking care of this cub. Is it so? Do you think this mother animal is very dedicated and a careful parent? Exactly. In the second picture, the cub says, "My mom teaches me how to build a nest. This is very a complex task." Being a cub, for him it's a complex task to build a nest. So it proudly says, "My mom teaches me how to build a nest." In the third picture, the cub says, "My mom teaches me how to find fruits that can be eaten." Sometimes we can see fruits that fruits may not be ripened, may not be eaten at the time. So we should wait till it turn ripen. So here the mother animal is teaching to the young one how to find fruits that can be eaten. I hope now you are able to know how the mother animals are very dedicated and careful parents. So these are the things we know from this iConnect part, how the mother animal is very dedicated and careful parent. Yes, my dear children, what do you think humans teach their young ones? Can you write down your response to this given question here? What do you think humans teach their young ones? For your better understanding, let me give you my own sentences. My mom teaches me how to comb my hair neatly. I hope your mother also taught you how to comb your hair neatly. My mom teaches me how to wash my clothes cleanly. Am I right, my dear children? Does your mother teach you how to wash your clothes cleanly? Obviously. I hope all the mother, your mother and my mother, teaches how to comb our hair neatly and how to wash our clothes cleanly. So now I think you're able to know how the elder people, how the elder animal is always very dedicated and a careful parent to their young ones. Really, we are all blessed because our parents are dedicated and a careful parents. Here are some character sketches which is going to take in place in the story. Let's we see what are all the characters going to take place in this story one by one. Mowgli, a young boy, he is the major and center character of this story. Father Wolf, Akila. Mother Wolf, Raksha. My dear children, Raksha is a word which means protection, because always the mother creature is so sweet and so careful, so dedicated. So I hope it is a name very apt to the mother wolf. Pack, young wolves. Bahira, Black Panther, Mowgli's best friend and guide. Baloo, he is also Mowgli's friend but a sleepy brown bear. Shere Khan, Tiger, Mowgli's enemy, the villainous animal in this story. He is always aiming at the young boy Mowgli. He wanted to destroy him. So let's we see what is a real thing taken place between the major character Mowgli and Shere Khan. Mowgli is also a major character, Shere Khan is also a major character, but Mowgli is a boy to be protected from the villainous, from the major character of a villainian, Shere Khan. And the last character of this story is Tabaki, Jackal, a mischief maker. Now we are going to listen an interesting story of a young boy who grew up in the jungle with some animals. Mowgli is a boy who grew up in the jungle and guided by his friends Bahira the panther and Baloo the bear. He grew up with the cubs and grown wolves. Cubs, young wolves, grown wolves means elder wolves. Mowgli grew up with the young wolves and the grown wolves. And Father Wolf taught him the meaning of things in the jungle. We saw always the mother character so concerned to the young one, so dedicated to the young one, and always a careful parent. Not only a mother creature, but also a father wolf. Here, the father wolf is taking a very good concern and dedicated. Father wolf taught him the meaning of things in the jungle. Every rustle in the grass, every breath of the warm night air, every note of the owls above his head, every scratch of a bat's claws as it roosted for a while in a tree, and every splash of every little fish jumping in a pool. These are all the meaning of things in the jungle which is taught by Father Wolf to Mowgli. What does this meaning of things in the jungle really mean? As I told you before, Mowgli is a boy, he is a major character, and Shere Khan is also a major character, but who is always doing bad thing to the young boy. Villainous character is Shere Khan. So Father Wolf wanted to protect Mowgli from the villainous character Shere Khan. So he taught many things in the jungle, because living in the jungle is not an easiest task. So he is teaching some meaningful things to protect himself in the jungle. every rustle in the grass. Yes, my dear children, when we walk on dried leaves, how does the sound will be? Right? When we see somebody's or walking on the dried leaf, we can identify, we know that people are walking, right? When we are not looking at them, but we hear only the sounds, immediately we strike things, somebody's are coming. This is what. So father wolf taught Mowgli, when you hear the rustle in the grass, you should be very careful, because that may be a villainous character, Shere Khan. So father wolf is always dedicated and a careful parent to the young boy. And every breath of the warm night air, what does it mean, breath of the warm night air? Which means there was a breath of danger in the air. When the tiger is coming on the way of Mowgli, it is really a danger will be taken place at the time. So father wolf is telling to Mowgli, breath of the warm night air. We cannot believe Shere Khan might come at night time. So you may face danger at night. So that breath of the warm night air really mean there was a danger of a breath in the air. Every note of the owls above his head, above your head, Mowgli, you may find, you may hear some particular sound of owl. Owl shouts only at night. Owl awaken only at night. So basically, owl is a bird which always are roaming only at night. When it sound, that sound will be a bad sign. So father wolf is telling to Mowgli, when you hear this particular sound from owl, you should be very careful. Maybe a harm is going to happen to you. Every scratch of a bat's claws as it roosted in a while at a tree. Every scratch of a bat's claws. We find bats in a tree only at night time. Only at night time the bats, owls are roaming and shouting. These two birds are always considered a bad sign. When it giving sound, it is a bad sign. So we should be very careful. Every splash of every little fish jumping in a pool. When the villainous animal may walk in the small river or in a small pool, the little fish would jump because of the wave of someone's walk in the pool. So father wolf is teaching all the meaning of things in the jungle. Everything should be noted by Mowgli. You should be very careful, Mowgli. So these are all the meaning of things in the jungle which is taught by father wolf to Mowgli, because he was a young boy. So he is not aware of these many things in the jungle. As I already said, living in the jungle is not an easiest task. When he was not learning, he sat out in the sun and slept and ate and went to sleep again, because he was not learning. So he doesn't know anything. So he sat out in the sun and sleep and enjoy the day and night and ate and went to sleep again. So eating, sleeping and sitting out in the sun, this was his routine. When Mowgli felt himself dirty or hot, he swam in the forest pools. Children, when you feel yourself dirty and hot, what do? You just take a bath. the same was happened to Mowgli. When Mowgli felt himself very dirty and hot, he takes bath, he swims in the forest pool. And when Mowgli wanted honey, he climbed up for honey. That too, it was taught by Bahira. Bahira showed Mowgli how to climb trees for honey. I hope now you are able to know how many characters are in the story and what are all their roles, how they are playing in their role. Now, for your better understanding, here are some questions. Let's enlighten our mind. Who are Mowgli's friends? Bahira the panther, Baloo the bear. Who are Mowgli's friends? Bahira the panther, Baloo the bear. With whom did Mowgli grow up? Mowgli grew up with the cubs, young wolves, and grown wolves. I hope you know the meaning of the word cub and grown wolf. Cub, young wolves. Grown wolves, elder wolves. Who are Mowgli's friends? Bahira, Baloo. Here is a question. What are the things that Father Wolf taught Mowgli? What are the things that Father Wolf taught Mowgli? The meaning of things in the jungle. What are the meaning of things in the jungle? A rustle in the grass, every breath of the warm night air, every note of the owls, every scratch of a bat's claws as it roosted in a tree, every splash of every little fish jumping in a pool. These are all the meaning of things in the jungle which is taught by Father Wolf to Mowgli. Now, let's have a look on this worksheet 1.1. Here is a telephonic conversation which takes place between a caller and a receiver. Who is a caller? A person who is making call is a caller. Who is a receiver? A person who is going to pick up the call is a receiver. Now, let's identify who is a caller, who is a receiver. Listen to Dhruv speaking on the phone. Who is he speaking to and what is he saying? Listen carefully and number the dialogues in the correct order. Yes, my dear children, here is a telephonic conversation which is unscrambled. Now we are going to read, listen, and number the dialogues in the right order. When telephonic conversation takes place, not only a telephonic conversation, when a conversation takes place, two of them will be interacted one by one with each other. If I am talking to someone else, I may talk something and then opposite person and the second party may respond to my talk. The same will be here in this telephonic conversation. One caller or receiver will be the initiative talker and the second party is a person who will be the respond. Hello. I hope you may know when a telephonic conversation takes place, the initiative talk word is hello. I hope the first word is already in the order. Hello. Now we are going to identify what is the Second telephonic conversation. I hope the caller may be the introducing. Hello, this is Patrick. May I speak to Mrs. Mugaji, please? My dear children, do you able to identify who is Patrick and who is Dhruv? Here, this man who is on ash color blazer, he is a man, Uncle Patrick, and a boy who is on yellow t-shirt, he is a receiver, Dhruv, a young boy, Dhruv. Now, who is telling hello? Exactly, Dhruv. Now, Dhruv says hello. Now, Uncle Patrick says, hello, this is Patrick. May I speak to Mrs. Mugarji, please? Now Dhruv speak. Hi, Uncle Patrick. This is Dhruv. Mummy has gone to the park with the pebbles and she has left her cell phone at home. May I take a message? The fourth one is, hello Dhruv, how are you? Because the previous conversation, Dhruv introduced himself by telling his name, this is Dhruv. So now the uncle may inquire how the boy is. Hello Dhruv, how are you? The next conversation is about this. I am fine, Uncle Patrick. I hope you are well. Now, listen, could you ask your mother to send me her dentist phone number? Avi has a really bad toothache and our dentist is out of town. Sure, Uncle. I'll ask Mummy to send you the dentist number as soon as she is back. I hope Avi gets better soon. Thanks, Dhruv. I'll bring Avi over when he's better. Bye. Bye, Uncle. So these are all the conversation when a telephonic conversation takes place. The initiative talk will be there and a respond will be there. Again, a conversation will be there to the respond. Likewise, at a conversation takes place when we have a telephonic conversation. For our better understanding, let's we have this number filled box. Shall we all together read this telephonic conversation once again with the right number? Hello. My dear children, you can see the numbers and listen to the conversation. Hello. Hello, this is Patrick. May I speak to Mrs. Mugarji, please? Hi, Uncle Patrick. This is Dhruv. Mummy has gone to the park with the pebbles and she has left her cell phone at home. May I take a message? Hello, Dhruv. How are you? I am fine, Uncle Patrick. I hope you are well. Listen, could you ask your mother to send me her dentist phone number? Abby has a really bad toothache and our dentist is out of town. Sure, Uncle, I'll ask Mummy to send you the dentist number as soon as she's back. I hope Avi gets better soon. Thanks, Duru. I'll bring Avi over when he's better. Bye. Bye, Uncle. You listen this conversation according to the numbers filled in the boxes and you can enlighten your brain with the right understanding. I hope you enjoyed this telephonic conversation and make yourself aware of this telephonic conversation. I hope you had a better day today with the interesting lesson. Meet you all with an interesting part of this lesson. Thank you. Thank you so much. Have a great day ahead.